rush hour at Sharm el-Sheikh International Airport. Hundreds of tourists line up for their first security checks. Everyone is searched, young and old. They're all waiting for a flight some officials aren't ready to put their citizens on. Thousands of passengers are stranded after their government's halted planes in and out of this airport. British authorities have asked for more security.
We feel like it will be probably the safest flight back that we'll probably ever have. So we're glad that the government are putting security measures in place for us.
Mary and Claire Frost are two of the British tourists stranded. For them, the trip home will be bittersweet. They stayed at the same hotel as some of the passengers killed on flight 9268.
So the night before, we'd been watching the little girls dancing and their parents singing, and then the next day they weren't there anymore, so it was really, really sad for us.
Egyptian authorities want to show the world the tragedy won't happen again. So they took us on a tour of the airport but wouldn't talk on camera.
Okay.
They showed us security for both passengers and employees.
Every employee who enters this airport is required to go through the same security screening as passengers. The only difference, they're required to have special IDs.
We're shown the area where they scan the luggage. They use X-ray machines and equipment that can detect explosives. Here's a room where they monitor cameras located throughout the airport. And they say they've taken an extra security step for British passengers.
2 years ago, British authorities requested that this machine be used before every flight to the United Kingdom. It's capable of detecting explosives. Egyptian authorities say that this kind of machine is not used on any other flights.
Officials have promised to increase security, but tell us it's too soon to say what more will be done to reassure everyone that it's safe to go home. Erin McLaughlin, CNN, Sharm el-Sheikh International Airport.